Just a quick question. Are there Albanians in the house tonight? This main event, Canada versus Albania. Yeah, my Canadians in the house tonight. Are you guys ready for the main event of the evening? This is for the TXT Lightweight Championship. Referee in charge of the action, Vance Swearedon. Judges, Shannon Hale and Morrell, Joe Poplar, physicians, Dr. Cross and Dr. Samet. We have timekeeper, Trevor Corwin and Dan Kalinowski. Inspector in charge, Jesse Lopez, and department rep, Linda Douglas. We are ready to get it on! First up, making his way to the cage, fighting out of the red corner. From Canada, put your hands together for Kyle, the Monster!
Kyle Nelson, 24 years old, coming to us out of Huntsville, Ontario. Weighed in at 154.6 pounds. Undefeated, 6-0 as a professional mixed martial artist. After a little drama at the weigh-ins last night. Looking for a very quality fight out of these two tonight. Of course, if you've seen Adrian fight before, you know half this crowd. Talk about walking into hostile territory, folks.
Adrian
Hadribeaj coming to us by way of Tirana, Albania. 4-0 as a professional. If you've seen him fight, absolutely one of the most exciting fighters in the division. And it is going to get very difficult to hear myself think in this place in just a second. Because if you're watching at home, you can see half this crowd here waving Albanian flags. Hard not to get caught up in the emotion of this. Fighting out of Fuse MMA, trained by Joel Battaglia, Don Richard, Ben Lagan. Talk about cooling down an opponent. Oh my God, poor Kyle. Poor Kyle Nelson sitting over there wondering what the hell is going on.
All right, fight fans, it is time for your TXC MMA Undisputed Legend 6 event of the evening. It is brought to you by OaklandTactical.com and PatinoDiet.com. Again, this is for the TXC Lightweight Championship, Team Canada versus Team Albania. And here we go. Two undefeated fighters, and to my left, fighting out of the red corner, weighing 154 and a half pounds, stands 5'10" tall, comes to us with an undefeated record of 6 wins, no losses. He is trained by Alan Halmaji out of Hentzville, Ontario, Canada. Put your hands together once again for Kyle the Monster Nelson. And to my right, fighting out of the blue corner, weighing 156 pounds, standing 5'10" tall, also coming to us with an undefeated record of 4 wins, no losses. He is trained by Joe Battaglia, Don Richard, and Ben Lagman out of Fuse MMA. Put your hands together once again for Adrian Chapunya, the Eagle. Van Swerden to give instructions.
All right, guys, this fight's for the vacant lightweight belt. We've been over the rules. Do I have any questions from the red corner? Any from the blue? Touch gloves here, come out fighting.
Somebody's O must go, a new champion crowned tonight.
All right, fight fans, when we get started, Kyle Nelson fighting out of the red corner, black trimmed in white shorts. ADRIAN HADRIBEAJ fighting out of the blue corner, black compression shorts.
Man, this is like what they feel in soccer stadiums. It's kind of excitement, liveliness, people on chairs, chanting.
Except this is a sport. That's right.
The soccer great athletes. Mixing things up, dropping his head down, and just coming straight forward is Kyle the Monster.
Kyle, yeah, this is not afraid to come forward and doing the real smart not being a stationary target.
Well, he does a great job at offense to defense. I mean, he keeps his hands up well, rolls his shoulders forward, so he's got a little extra defense, doesn't have his chin in the air. You know, and these are heavy kicks that Adrian has, and we know that about him. He stays at a perfect range and lands these long shots.
And they come from everywhere, Kara.
Well, that's what's tricky. I mean, the funny thing about people with their hands down is it's actually a lot harder to block. I mean, they're more susceptible, but the shots are harder to block because you don't see where they're coming from.
Just like that. He was looking high and went low with it. Brought it right across the knee, and you can already see a little bruise.
Do you see how he locks up at the end of every shot? Every shot is hard. You can see the way he rolls his shoulder at the end of a shot, locks his whole body to it, lands a head kick on Kyle, and Kyle just walks
Kyle
through it and lets
kept
his hands
coming.
Go.
Managed to score a few of his own, but then Adrian playing Matador and sidestepping a big overhand right.
You know, definitely Kyle doing a great job moving side to side. You cannot sit there, you know, and be a target for Adrian. And Adrian will mix it up. Look at that. Leg kick coming up with the head shots. You never know where it's going to come from.
And he very seldom throws just a single shot. He's always stringing them together.
You know, Adrian likes to keep his range, but I think when Kyle moves to his left, he should cut him off and then drop that overhand left as he's standing southpaw right now. You know, he's made Kyle a little more tentative to come in. You know, Kyle was a little more confident at the beginning of the round.
I don't think there's a whole lot of appreciation for exactly how hard Adrian hits until you are at the end of one.
Well, you can see it just in the way his body locks at the end of every shot.
Nelson scoring a couple there.
Yeah, but Adrian coming back beautiful. Hook right hand right there, landing clean. You know, complete strategic matchup here. You know, and Adrian's better with a guy on their feet. It makes his... You know, he's got a target right there for him.
Halfway through this first round, Adrian twitches his hips and Kyle jumps. Big heavy kick. Wow.
Adrian just looks ridiculously strong.
Turned him over with the chancery, wound up on top, threw about three shots as he was standing up. Now he's got to look to create some sort of separation here. His corner telling him get the high underhook.
He bumps himself off the cage and turns things around. It's just his power just looks like he's overpowering Kyle at this point. But, you know, a lot of that has to do with his balance and body mechanics. He does that so well.
He's incredibly efficient. I mean, Kyle representing himself well in there.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what a great opponent for Adrian as well. Both of these guys will take a lot away from this fight. You know, the problem is Kyle not wanting to commit, because as soon as you do, you're going to get a 3-4-5 piece coming right back at you.
Absolutely, and it's about 95% accurate when it comes. Big heavy kick to the inside there.
Mixing it up. Never know what.
Well, even that spinning back kick, it didn't quite land, but it was right where it was supposed to be, even though Kyle was moving very hard to his right.
And this is where, what Kyle, truthfully, you're almost going to have to pot shot. You're going to go in with a shot and get going.
He's had a little success with those.
You know, but he's doing a good job of adapting too, Kyle. You know, at first he was coming in, bombs blazing. He's had to change his tactic up a little bit.
That's got to be exhausting, though, because for every 10 steps he takes, Adrian in the center of the cage is taking half the steps, doing half the work.
And that's the great thing. When you know how to cut off the cage, cut off a ring, you make your life so much easier, and you have that guy just on their bike the whole time.
10 seconds. This crowd here hoping for a first-round knockout. Not going to get it.
A big slam going in the favor of Kyle. And who knows with a little bit more time right there.
Adrian doing a good job of popping back up. You can tell he's been working that ground game. He might not be an offensive machine from there, but his defense has improved greatly.
But I think this is where Kyle, you know, corner, looks at that blueprint, changes things up, and saw what worked and what didn't work. And there are some things that definitely didn't work because of the speed and accuracy of Adrian. Kyle's got to come back in. He's got a pot shot and move and maybe look to take Adrian down, because in the past, that's been the weaker spot on Adrian. You know, he's working on it, getting better and better, but that's been the one, you know, part that he's had to work on more, because his stand-up is so solid.
And he's got to score when he gets in there, that's for sure.
Both of these guys undefeated coming in this cage, and you can tell, I mean, they both deserve to be there, because we've seen what most people look like on the other side of Adrian's hands and feet.
Oh, it's a long, bad day, absolutely. even when it's a 30-second knockout, it's still a long day.
Well, we know Canadians are tough, very tenacious, and they come to fight, they come in shape. A lot of times go long times between fights because of the access to actually getting pro fights.
Speaking of Canadians, how'd you guys ever let Woody in the country?
We love
How'd
Woody.
He get to stay there?
Because he drinks a lot of beer. Supports our economy. Here we go. Adrian, you know, hands down. And that's what's more difficult to read a fighter. Big head kick.
Clean shot.
This is exactly what Kyle needs to do. Just those pot shots. One shot at a time and move. Because Adrian will explode on you at any time with 4 and 5 shots. Great adaptation between the first and the second round. Got, you know, and you have to be in condition to do what Kyle's doing as well. You know, take some of these shots, but keep moving.
And see, this is when Adrian's at his best, when he's throwing volume.
Yeah, and he's so accurate.
Not trading single shots back and forth.
And look at the focus. I mean, he's so completely focused 100% of the time, and that's a key too.
He's getting sucked into Nelson's game a little bit. At least he was. Now here we go with the volume again.
Well, this is what he does really well. He keeps his hands forward when he's punching. So a lot of people will pull their arm back like Robin Hood, bow and arrow style, and he keeps them forward, so they just come at you like a pelican. They pop, 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 pop. It's really hard to get away from that.
How do they come at you?
Like this, pop, 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 pop. Oh, this is where Kyle can't stop. He can't get into that where he's trying to sit in the pocket, because it's just too easy. It's a heavy bag for Adrian.
Oh, absolutely.
Adrian took that kick just to drop a few shots. And that's what Adrian needs to do a little bit more, is he got to use some feints. You know, he kind of just waits to counter quite often. He's got to, like, create some of those counters. Draw the counter out. Make the guy punch, kick, and then you can go off that shot. Cutting the cage off very well. Inside leg kick. You know, working either side of the leg, but you're seeing the red spots on the legs of Adrian as well. Kyle doing a good job.
Oh, Kyle's no slouch.
No, my gosh, he's great. And, I mean, to see the head kick he delivered earlier, I mean, that's where, you know, he should look to go back there again, try to set it up.
And conversely, whenever Adrian is throwing those high-volume shots, Kyle is completely defensive. All he is doing is trying to get out of the cage at that point, and that is what Adrian needs to go back to.
Oh, Adrian sitting in the pocket, taking the kick and dropping the two down the pipe, rubbing that left hand as a southpaw.
I wonder if this is one of those times where he's just not used to a guy being able to weather this storm the way Kyle Nelson has.
The bravery of Kyle coming forward, continuing to throw. Adrian so accurate, fighting, backing up.
That's what I'm talking
these
about.
Two.
Adrian's never had somebody to be able to stand with him like this before.
No.
And that's got to be a new paradigm for him. And he needs to fight through it.
He's done such a good job of rolling his shoulders forward, rounding his back, and keeping his chin low. He's able to come through with a lot of shots and multiple punches. Adrian, great down the pipe. And he throws it more down the pipe than anything. So Kyle should transfer his backhand in the front of his face just a little bit more so that you're catching that shot without even trying. Because you're not seeing.
And we got somebody chiming in from Canada. Woody says, Kyle's 145, that's why.
Right down the pipe, coming around the outside. And that's what you always have to do. You have to go down the pipe, then come around the side. You can't just go down the pipe the whole time.
Oh! And that's that, folks.
Well,
looking for the leg lock.
We'll see what Kyle can do from here. A little flash knockdown.
Adrian's got to be careful. At this point,
they're just so
slippery. Let him stand and back up.
It's hard to
make him stand back up. You know, absolutely.
He caught that right down the pipe, dropped him. Might be a broken nose. Anytime you see that split on the nose, quite often, you are seeing a broken nose.
Adrian wisely getting back to his feet. Not nearly enough ground seasoning. Oh, beautiful.
You know, so accurate right there.
Nearly enough time on the ground to sit there and try to play patty cake in a leg lock like that. Get back to your feet.
A big looping overhand left from Adrian, just kind of having his way with him. He should really put his foot on the gas and try and stop Kyle, but Kyle, man, he's tough. You can't take too many chances with him as well.
No, 17 seconds left, Kara. We're probably going to make it into round three.
But you can see why Kyle's an undefeated fighter. I mean, there's no way he's fought anyone of this caliber of hands and feet.
Well, now desperation on the part of Kyle Nelson. He wants to get this fight back to the ground in the worst way. And Adrian may not have a lot of offensive skills on the ground, but he's done a great job of keeping himself on his feet.
Well, that's your number one job as a coach. If you have a talented fighter, as talented as Adrian on his feet, teach them anything and everything to get out of groundwork. You know, teach sprawls, teach anything that you can.
Look at the speed of those shots.
As I'm telling you, the reason he's so great at that is he keeps his hands in front of him and just uses his shoulders and pushes his hands forward. He doesn't load up. He doesn't pull his hands back. He's able to get that kind of speed coming off of both hands.
And right there, wisely doing everything exactly right to get out of that knee bar attempt and not going back for a third helping.
You know, and getting the message from one of the promoters in Canada, Woody, and, you know, letting us know we're seeing Kyle normally at 145 stepped up to take this fight, and this is a big step up. You're not facing just like, let me see what I feel like at 55. Let me see what the best is at 55. But I mean, Kyle's already shown us how much courage he has by some of the shots he's taken, coming back, puts his head down, fires, put punches together. A lot of people would have been already done by now.
And he can take a shot. The problem is with Hadribeaj, you're taking 40 of them.
And
they
hard.
Just keep coming, absolutely. Adrian Hadribeaj in the black compression shorts, smelling blood at this point.
You know, Kyle doing a great job of bringing his hands back up after he kicks, after he punches, you know, learning that that's the best way. You got to get a shield up there. You got to have a tuck defense to prevent some of those shots from coming through. Kyle's still walking Adrian down. And again, this is where you feint Adrian. You've got to feint him and draw some of these crazy combinations and jump on him when he's done.
And you can see the back of that right thigh of Adrian's.
Yeah, both of them are pretty beat up. See, and the thing with Adrian, normally people, when they kick you like that, you can jump on them. You never know what weapons are coming next from Adrian. It's a kind of jumping into the fire. Look at the heart of Kyle.
Oh, there's no quitting him. Adrian's going to have to shut him off if he wants to end this fight early.
Unreal. What a great main event here for our TXC Lightweight Championship. I love the movement of Kyle. I love the head movement, the hands up. Adrian, though, he looks very relaxed that he can push the pace at any time.
Well, he is definitely getting looser as we go on in the rounds here.
You know, nice pivot off Adrian had over to his right, standing as a southpaw. And that's what you do, hook around a lot. Come around your opponent, make them look for you. See, when Adrian cuts off, meaning when he finishes punching, that's when you have to jump on him, because he swims his hands down. He doesn't bring them back up at all. So that's the only time he's kind of vulnerable for headshots. But the kicks are always there too, that you have to be aware of. Kyle's got to feint. He's got to draw out these shots from Adrian, take a half step back, and then jump on him.
Halfway through this third round here,
Hadribeaj
just absolutely settled into his fight right now.
From
Kara,
the side of the cage, you could hear how heavy that leather is, how hard it's landing. How many people can we name that would be sitting in here still coming forward, you know, taking these shots. Kyle Nelson, definitely a warrior.
Well, he's going to stay there, and he's going to fight until the fight's over, until it's over for him.
Yeah.
That's outstanding.
Well, just Adrian putting on a clinic, though, to be honest. You know, he's not getting much damage, coming around, stepping out, fighting his game.
No, and it's gotten worse as the fight's
gone
on.
Yeah, and I mean, you're seeing a guy with so much heart and talent in Kyle Nelson, but Adrian just, it's a shutout. This is just letting you know the level of talent from this guy.
I'm just really impressed with how he has elevated his takedown defense at this point.
Well, I think he learned a little bit from Bellator, too. He had some tough fight in Bellator where it was taken to the ground. Wasn't sure if he had won the fight.
And as I say it, he's about to get dumped on his back here.
Yeah, but you'll get a chance to see how he works off his back now. We don't get to see that very often.
Well, Kyle Nelson at this point has a lot of time to work here. 1:20 left. He just can't get caught into a patty cat game like this. He's got to look for submissions. You can't let Adrian pop up. Bringing that head over the neck now. Trying to cradle Adrian up. Nice transitions into full mount.
You know, and I think with only 1 minute left, I think if Kyle has a lot of success here, he's going to kick himself in the butt later for not doing this sooner.
He's got to finish it right now. If it gets stood back up again,
definitely.
He probably won't get this opportunity. Adrian giving up his back. He's got to keep, see how he's got his head nice and high, hard to choke here, or you got to get the small of the back towards the mat. Got to be careful he doesn't get himself choked out.
I think, honestly, they're too slippery. At some point, they're just kind of slippery.
Got to keep working to get his back to the mat here. He'll take some punishment, but he will not get choked out. Right now, it's back in Kyle Nelson's world. 20 seconds. This will be a little heart test for Adrian here because he is definitely out of his element.
They're lucky this isn't 5 rounds either, because once you've solved this Adrian problem of, like, you've got to go to the ground.
That's it. Coming to the end of this round, Kara. Even if you want to be generous and give this round to Kyle Nelson.
I don't think that last, 20 seconds warrants that.
Are we 5 rounds in this?
Apparently. This is 5. All right, it is a 5-round fight. And I'm the last to know. I'm the announcer, right?
Why would I know these? I'm the last to know. You knew just before I did.
You know what? Fantastic news for Kyle Nelson, a 5-round fight. He solved the Adrian mystery.
He didn't solve anything. He took
Steve,
him down
yeah.
and then couldn't finish.
He took him down and he wasn't getting pieced up.
That's like saying hi to the girl and not getting her number.
No, you know? At least you got the confidence to approach someone that hot, right?
Yeah.
So this is the thing. He solved it a little bit and he's getting smarter by the round, but now Adrian knows he doesn't want to go to the ground with him, so it's going to up his game too. We're going to see an even better 4th round. And I think Adrian's really going to bring it this round.
We're going to see an Adrian looking to finish Kyle Nelson at this point.
Well, that's what I was saying last round. It felt like he was coasting, that he could explode at any minute, because we were working off a 3-round war. Now with 5 rounds.
Now it makes sense. Into the championship rounds here. Deepwater, 4th round.
You know, and this is where maybe Kyle's going to look for that takedown. Close the gap and get back to the mat. 4th round in this TXE Lightweight Championship, belt vacant.
Both of these guys giving every fan in here their money's worth and then some.
Oh, another hit kick, the same place it landed last time he threw it. Doing a good job of moving around as Nelson. Adrian does such a great job of cutting off the cage, though. Oh,
big heavy kick again.
Man.
And you can see now that we're into the 4th round. Kyle is favoring that left leg just a little bit. And Adrian saw it too. I like the strategy of wearing the long shorts because you can't see those giant bruises appear on the back of the thigh.
It's like being able to see blood, right?
Absolutely.
Oh, yep, here we go.
Nice
man,
chance
great
ran out.
Job.
And that was a statement from Adrian.
Yeah. Great accurate shot. He throws that so quick because he sneaks his hand, he creeps it forward before he fires it, and it's already that much closer to his target. His spacing and range and accuracy is just so on point that that's why people get hurt. You know, if you get someone with your full leverage, your full range, that's where the damage comes in.
Well, we've been impressed with his striking since he stepped into the cage for the first time. What's impressed me is watching him evolve the rest of his game.
But as you said, how many times has he faced a fighter like this that's willing to fight back?
That was beautiful.
Yeah.
Caught the high kick and chopped the base leg out. That's Brad Burrick at work right there. I used to love watching Brad fight for the same reason. Nobody goes to the base leg like Burrick does, but Adrian is a really close second on that.
Well, Adrian has these like freakishly fast twitch muscles in everything that he does.
Look at the thigh through the slit in the shorts of Kyle Nelson. It looks like he's sunburned and bruised at the same time.
But Adrian's front leg isn't looking too hot either. You know, he's taking a lot of those leg kicks.
He'd get that if he sat Indian style. Are you kidding me? It's not even close.
Oh, big loop and overhand right. Adrian pivots around. He backs up and then sits in the pocket. You know, these are real fighters. You know, when you see guys running is one thing. These guys sit in the pocket, catch shots, grab shots, look to fire back.
No matter
That's
what
the crazy
happens
switch in your head.
In the rest of this fight, Kyle Nelson has established that he is
a serious
fighter, highly talented, incredibly skilled, and with more heart than most three people.
Yeah. Oh, half step back, drops the right hand. Great timing, great accuracy. Oh, yeah, if he doesn't get a round of applause from this crowd, there's something wrong. Because you're not a great champion unless you face a great opponent. And Kyle, a great opponent.
Minute 30 left in this fourth round.
Oh, nice. He throws the jab and then the hook left hand is setting it up. I'd like to see that a little bit more from Adrian.
But Kyle just keeps stalking him down.
Yeah, but Adrian is just that has that half step back that keeps rearranging himself. You know, pulls himself out of Kyle's range and puts himself where he knows it's just one step away from a shot. This is where Adrian always has to like really work on his conditioning because he loads up on everything. He locks up on every shot, and it's hard to fight like that. And Adrian fights like that every round.
Every punch.
Every shot he throws is that lockup.
See, now here we need to see some knees from him to create that separation.
Now, did we have Adrian at 170 in his previous fights or 55? Because I seem to remember some fights at 170.
Maybe early on.
Yeah. He's definitely come down. Kyle's going up.
Kyle going to get the takedown here. Oh, he slipped up.
He looks like he kind of went in rest mode for a second.
He sure did. Just didn't have the energy to finish it.
Wow, coming to the end of
Adrian with a takedown and doesn't follow him.
But come on, he just looks that much stronger.
That is absolutely an I own you. Steps to the outside.
Like when you are
Nelson on his back and walks away.
When you are strong like Adrian but have such body awareness of balance and position, I mean, he's making it look so easy. Man, big shout out to Albania. Big shout out to Huntsville, Ontario, Canada. These fighters representing you guys so well. Unbelievable. You know, this is Adrian's dream. Came over to the States to make this happen, and he's making it happen and has brought the entire country with him.
It's infectious. When you were in there, and I said, it's hard not to be emotional over this.
Yeah.
You know, you got all of these people. I'm not a big fan of the booing. Need to get that under control.
Yeah. I doubt we'll see that at the end. I think at the beginning it's just an intimidation aspect.
All right, here we go into the deep water, fifth and final round. This TXC lightweight championship. At this point, Kyle Nelson has to be thinking, I need to knock him out or submit him to win. And after 20 minutes of fighting, Adrian Hadribeaj would probably like to just go home right now, put an end to this.
Yeah, it seemed like he was just kind of testing himself. He had a little bit trouble making weight yesterday, and maybe he didn't have as much confidence in himself to go five rounds, just kind of seeing how he would do with five fives. And, you know, doing a great job. But when you're as skilled as him, you can take your time. You know, someone's, if they push the pace on you, you have an answer. Adrian does a great job of circling as well.
He does. I don't like to see him when he's just looking to counter. And
that's
it seems like that's where
game.
He's at right now.
You know, I like to see him do a little bit more in and out. He used to come in with a jab, come pop back out on defense, come right back in with shots, which is always a great tactic.
Well, he's figured out Kyle Nelson hits hard. I don't think he's been hit that hard yet
fight. But that is exactly why he needs to go back to in and out. He throws the jab, pulls out, draws Kyle's punches, and comes back in with his shots.
Again, Kyle Nelson going to sell out to the takedown. Adrian Hadribeaj just so strong.
Yeah, he
definitely doing such a good job of getting that underhook. That may be the last hurrah of Kyle Nelson. That had to be exhausting.
I know, but look, he never gets mentally defeated. He still comes forward. He's still looking to take him out. Two undefeated fighters trying to win the title, trying to keep their undefeated record. You know, but just Adrian just making it look easy, to be honest. Kyle's definitely a challenge, but Adrian's still no worse for wear.
Well, the challenge that Kyle has presented is Adrian can't stop him, and that's new for him.
And has had five rounds to do so. But, I mean, Adrian's not really pushing the pace.
He's just got to make sure that he doesn't give up a takedown in the next 2.5 minutes.
Adrian just sat into that kick and threw his hands. It does. See, and that's why Adrian's so dangerous. He could fight so well backing up. And a lot of people can't fight well backing up. They can't fight well going to the opposite side. Their back leg, Adrian can do both. The fact that Kyle is still walking him down is amazing to me.
Wow. Ole.
Kyle's definitely made some attempts of going for broke, knowing that that's what he has
2 minutes
to do to
left,
take his title.
Kara. It's times like this when I just have to be reminded and remind people I'm the luckiest MMA fan on the planet. To be so close to all of this incredible action.
I mean, I like the way that Kyle's stalking him, but he's got to do something with it. You can't really wait for Adrian's shots because they may come in five and six.
Or they're
pieces.
Not coming at all. Adrian's waiting for Kyle to commit before he does something.
Well, Adrian knows, right? He's got it in the bag so far. So Kyle's really got to just go forward and let his hands go. Let his kicks. He's had a lot of success with his kicks. He's landed two big head kicks.
1 minute left. If Kyle Nelson is going to pull this fight out, he's got to go now.
He's got to just try and make something happen. And there he goes. Oh, but the footwork of Adrian just stymieing that. For those kind of situations, you can't go straight in. You kind of have to shuffle back and forth, side to side before you shoot, so they don't know what direction you're coming in from. Adrian gonna pick up the pace a little bit with just over 30 seconds left. And this is what he needs to do to give his fans, you know, get those hands moving. Go for broke now yourself. Let yourself wear out in that cage.
Well, Kyle Nelson cold comfort that it's going to be, can consider it an accomplishment that he stood in there for 25 minutes.
Toe-to-toe, standing up, as you said. I mean, we're not talking about getting him to the ground. He stood in front of him, walked him down.
What a fight.
And there we go. What a fantastic main event here at the Suburban Collection Showplace, the TXC lightweight title between Kyle the Monster Nelson and Adrian the Eagle Hadribeaj.
How'd you say that? Hadribeaj, is that it? I say it wrong differently every time we do a show and he fights. TXC crowd anxiously awaiting the judges' final tally here on this championship bout. But it should come as no surprise to anyone. About as one-sided as a fight could be, where one fighter didn't get wheeled out on the bus. Kyle Nelson demonstrating a lot of skill, a lot of heart, resilience, tenacity, everything that is good about a fighter and about this sport. Just bit off a little bigger bite than was chewable on this occasion.
Let's hear it for both of these fighters in your main event of the evening. Make some noise. In the lightweight championship, we go to the scorecards after five rounds of fighting. Judge Shannon Hale, Judge Ann Morrell, and Judge Joe Poplar all score the bout 49-46 in favor of your winner and new TXC lightweight champion. Put your hands together for Adrian Shapunya! Champion unless you faced a tough challenger. So let's give it up for Kyle the Monster Nelson with an outstanding fight. Adrian, congratulations. First off, how does this feel? Five round fight, your first time ever, and you are the new TXC champ.
Oh, actually I felt great. You know, I've been having a tough training. So, you know, it wasn't that easy, it was a very tough fight. So I had to play more smart than with my skills. So that's where, you know, I wasn't able to survive five rounds and score on him.
You know, were you surprised? Because you landed some pretty heavy shots and he kept coming forward. How tough was that?
Yeah, it was tough, you know. I respect the opponent for coming all the way here. But I want to say, you know, I'm not here about, you know, for money or anything, you know. I'm here just to, you know, to step up, and I'm here for glory. That's why I build all this crowd right here.
Now you have people watching from all over America, all overseas as well. How much pressure do you feel? Because look at it in here. I mean, it's unbelievable the amount of energy. How much pressure do you feel coming in here and putting on a great performance and getting the win?
Look, my support is keep growing, you know, being bigger and bigger all over the world here. And everything since 25 minutes ago was like perfect, you know. All this beautiful crowd we support, all the people from my family watching from Albania. So everything was so perfect, and I was the only one I should take this belt home.
Now, talk to me about your training leading up to this fight. We've always known you're fantastic on your feet. Your range is beautiful. You lock up on every shot. You hit so hard, throw bunches of punches. But now your takedown defense was outstanding as well. Clearly, you've been working on that. Talk to me about your training.
Of course, I have most top trainers on the stage, you know. Start with head coach Joe Battaglia, Don Richard, James Lee, and Ben. And I have in a sparring trainer partners from coming from wrestling background. So they, you know, I've been just keep working, you know, and I'm committing on it.
Now, what can you take away from this performance tonight? How do you feel about it?
Like, since last time and this time is always, you know, like one of the best nights of my life.
Fantastic. Any final thoughts or thank yous that you want to send out?
First, I want to thank God for keeping me stronger and believing in it. My family, from and all the family, all the support, all of everybody, and all these big, beautiful sponsors, you know, keep supporting me more and more every time and believing in me.
Well, Adrian, we have to tell you that you are an absolute pleasure. We get so excited to watch you fight, and we look forward to you fighting back in the cage again.
That's what I'm looking forward to, you know, to step up next time, you know, and have more crowd and, you know, everything bigger and bigger.
All right, the next great one right here, the Eagle, Adrian Hadribeaj. All right, Kyle. The amount of guts you have is almost scary. You face one of the top strikers probably in America right now, fighting at this level. Unbelievable, and you kept coming forward and coming forward. Talk to me about this fight.
Yeah, you know, I was excited to come in and fight. You know, I'm kind of the away guy, but I knew I could hold my own. So, you know, I was glad to come in and fight, and I hope I did a good job. I hope you guys enjoyed it.
I mean, you made this main event fantastic. Nobody has ever stood in front of Adrian for 5 rounds. You did something that nobody has ever had a chance to do. What can you take away from this fight?
You know, I'm getting better every day. So, you know, the fact that we went the distance, I think, means a lot. And I'm going to head back. I'm going to train. I'm going to get better than ever. And I'm going to come back. Maybe I'll come get that belt.
Yeah, and talk to me about that. Talk to me about your training camp leading up to this fight. Because you did an outstanding job.
Yeah, you know, I'm training hard every day. You know, I'm putting in, you know, I'm getting up and training hard in the morning. I'm jogging, you know, I'm doing everything right. So, you know, it's just a matter of time before I become the best. So.
Well, I think just getting an opportunity to see that level across the cage from you and sticking it out is going to elevate your game more and more. Congratulations, and thank you for bringing us such a fantastic fight.
Yeah, thank you, and thanks to all my sponsors, Moose Delaney's and everybody, and Kimura Wear and everybody. So thank you.
And we did get a text message as well while the fight was going on, talking about you typically fighting at 145. You know, how did that feel to step up to 55?
You know, I got offered a belt. You know, I'm a 145er. That's where I do my best, you know. But, you know, I got offered it, so I figured I'd step up and do it now. I'm going to go back down to 45, and then you're going to see me come home with the belt.
Well, your bravery is outstanding. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for having me, guys.
All right, once again, Kyle the Monster Nelson. All right, thank you once again to all our sponsors, Chris Trainer and Associates Law Firm, OaklandTactical.com, Tenacious MMA, PatinoDiet.com. Thank you to everyone for coming out tonight. Thank you for all your support and staying here and cheering on all the fighters. Without you guys, we don't have a show. Be safe, and thanks again to Joe Battaglia and Steph Battaglia for putting on such a great show. Have a good night, everyone.